Daredevil, we shouldn't go jump into the water and try rescuing people without ensuring the safety of others. So, okay, before moving on to the next speech, I want to add on to that list. The next group of people who helped us in this time are non-government organizations. Many such organizations took it upon themselves to distribute food packets, to provide relief to many people in need. Organizations like Sevalaya and Aid India still continue to give relief to many people in Tamil Nadu. Okay, now next speaker is Toastmaster Aishwarya. Before I call her, let me ask her evaluator, Toastmaster Ashish, to actually say.
Both are CC.
Okay, so now Toastmaster. I asked Toastmaster Aishwarya about her thoughts in this, about the theme, and she said these floods are just news for other people, but to us it is like a godsend. We should capitalize on this. We discovered the true power of people when they come together, and we should utilize that in the future. I welcome Toastmaster Aishwarya. Wade through the water, Toastmaster.
Good afternoon, dear Modi, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome guests. It's good to see you all. It was a busy working day. My manager had arranged for a quick meeting to inform everyone to leave by 8 o'clock as the captain not to come home. As all the roads adjoining my area were flooded and water might anytime enter our streets too. I turned on the television to see what my dad was talking about. Almost every part of the city was deluged and were under flood threats. When my landline went unanswered in the afternoon, I knew there was something wrong. I could reach only my brother. He said they had moved to a neighbor's house in third floor with some valuables and important documents, as knee-level water rose inside the house. By night, all my folks' phones went switched off. As I couldn't contact my family, I was glued to television, news channels, and Twitter page. Like how the roads were flooded with water, Twitter was flooded with messages both from victims who need help and from people who are ready to help in whichever way they can. Tweets about food drive. Messages from people who are willing to open their houses and properties for those who are stranded in streets. Tweets from relatives mounted on social media to alert the rescue teams and brave volunteers to check on their loved ones who are stuck in rooftops. The National Defence Force were deployed for rescue operations, were astounded to see more volunteers than victims. On one such evening, we all received a message in our medley group. It was a message composed by Biju Vargas called The Spirit of Chennai. This guy, who works in Qatar and has his family resides in Chennai, explained how Chennai stood together in the wake of calamity. This rich neighbor, who had never interacted with anyone in the neighborhood, opened this house for 35 people. This neighbor, who is a Hindu Brahmin, he provided mats for Muslims to do namaz. He allowed Christians to do prayer in his puja room. He said, we'll share whatever we have. You all can stay here till the water recedes. Biju mentioned that his wife told about a group of people who were wading through the water, through the neck deep water, and stopping in front of every house and asking, sir, madam, do you need any help? They provided food packets and essentials. They helped in whatever way they could. In that forward, Biju pointed out that this is what these kids were seeing. This is what they're learning. They're learning how to survive. They're learning how to get help and help each other in the time of need. And this is what he wants his kids to learn. After reading that message, I knew there are heroes out there to help my family and saviors to shelter them. When I knew water receded after 4 days, I went to check on my family. They were doing fine, but my house was a wreck. Shit. I looked at my dad, who looked exhausted. He said, "We lost all the household items."
It's a very touching speech.